It's time for the Giz Wiz with Mad's maddest writer, Dick DeBartolo. This is episode 1606, recorded Thursday, January 19th, 2017. Throw Mama from the microwave. On this episode of the Giz Wiz, we have more from CES. I have another present gadget from the crappy corner. Bruce has a fantastic warehouse, and you will enjoy this show. All coming up next on the Giz Wiz.
It's the same old show, Dickie D and OMG chat on your PC.
It's time for the Giz Wiz because gadgets are his business. They've got a gizmo sickness, geek disease,
a nerd pathology,
rows and rows of USBs, growing, glowing LEDs. Get ready for the Giz Wiz now.
Now it is time for the Giz Wiz, and here he is, the Wikipedia article on gadgets. Dick DeBartolo, how you doing, Dickie D?
I'm doing fine, sir. And you?
I'm doing well myself. It's been a pretty good week, I would say. How about you?
I've had a good week so far. I can't remember one thing I did.
Yeah,
But it's been good.
It's just been kind of one of those lazy weeks where everything is just fine. And
Yes, I know. I have to get like
eventful.
A yearly checkup with the doctor, and I went there yesterday, and normally it's like crazy, and I went in and like there was one person.
Oh, nice.
And I said to the guy, what's going on? And he said, no one does anything in January.
Everyone's still recovering from December is what's happening in January.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I guess, and also, you know, I've known a lot of people who have insurance policies that, It's like at the beginning of the year, it costs you tons. The end of the year, you've already hit it. You know, you've gotten sick a few times. You've done a few things. Okay, well, now it's all free money. Let's go crazy.
Yeah. That's exactly right. You have to work off all those deductibles.
Exactly. So in January, like, don't sneeze. No runny noses. We're going to plug your nose with cotton. Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, we still have tons of gadgets from CES.
We do, and we'll... Oh, wait a minute. We'll start with one with a what the heck is it?
Okay. Okay. I mean, my real guess is that it's a card reader. It's a SD card reader. Or...
In a mini, mini way, that could be considered correct.
Okay. Is it a portable battery?
No. No, you're closer with your other one.
In a mini, mini way.
No, they're saying battery. it's a toothpick. No.
I would have had so many other things, like it's a flashlight or it's a... But I'm closer with the...
Yeah, I love this. It's a digital harmonica. That's funny.
That's nice.
A mini LED light, a cracker toaster. Someone has the right answer, but I'll let the video show how right he is. Someone said, is it a computer?
Someone says, is a cell phone SD card reader? So like it connects wirelessly?
No, this happens to be, it'll spoil the video, but I'll tell you because it's fun. This is a Windows 10 computer.
You're kidding me. What? Let me see those ports. So is that a display port? What is that?
No. Those are cooling ports, okay?
Oh, my gosh.
And basically what it is, well, you'll see the video, but you are right. I say you're right in as much as this down here. That is a card you can put in a 512 gigabyte.
SD card.
Micro SD card to increase the memory because this just has 32 gigabyte. But this is how you use it, so let's watch our first video.
Okay, here we go.
Hey, Dickie Bartolo, Mad's Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're working by Kangaroo. We know them well. Remember a couple weeks ago we did our Best of Show, and a couple people had written in and said they bought the Kangaroo, and that was their favorite gadget that they bought for the year from the Giz Wiz. Well, we don't have a cameraman right now, so we drafted Pete. We'll learn if he's a good cameraman or not. So if he's not, Pete's fault. But I'm walking by and I see this guy. And you know, on the show we play What the Heck Is It? I defy you to guess what the heck that is. Okay? Well, we're at the kangaroo booth, so that might be a hint, because this is actually a computer.
That's
is that right.
right,
Ben?
Absolutely, you're right. It's a Windows 10 PC. It's basically a PC on a stick.
PC on a stick, and what do we do with it?
Well, basically, we've created a device which allows you to insert that PC into a notebook. And basically, the notebook has a display, a keyboard, a trackpad, and a battery. So now we've modulized the brains, the CPU, the RAM, the storage, so you can swap in different versions. Like, you've got one here. Right. There's one that's already in here.
Can you pull that out?
Yeah.
So, oh, do you push it in and then pull it out?
Right.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
And basically, what it allows you to do is that individuals can have their own PC.
And
wow.
It's not hot swappable. It's not hot swappable.
I just
That's sort
the
of the trade-off that we had with the original Kangaroo PC.
Oh,
the original one has a battery in it. This one does not.
Oh, okay.
And that's really because of the size limitations.
Okay. So now this is running off AC then.
Well, there's a battery inside. Once you have it inserted, it basically runs off either, obviously, the AC or the battery.
Okay. And do you know about how many hours of battery life you can get?
Yeah, depending on how heavily it's used, it's probably about 4 hours.
About 4 hours. That's the same as the Kangaroo, right?
That's right. That's right.
And the Kangaroo is now the Kangaroo Pro.
That's correct. We've upgraded the dock so you have a hard drive bay for additional storage, additional ports, VGA, audio, as well as the USB.
Let's see what that looks like. Oh, okay, we're bringing it over here. Okay, so this has all these inputs.
Right, Ethernet as well.
Right, so when we showed the Kangaroo, it was pull out the little Kangaroo.
Yep, it just slots right out.
So that's the actual little computer. Now, does this have the same power as that?
Yes, it's basically CPU-wise, it's the same. And the RAM and storage is identical.
Amazing. And the price point on this?
Right, so the Kangaroo Pro is $169. This one, again, two sticks and the screen and the notebook is $299.
$299, and basically the kids can have their own computer.
That's right.
And then
you can have one, the child has their own, so you can share the keyboard and the screen, but each individual has their own PC.
Okay, so the kangaroo, what's it called?
Well, it's Kangaroo Notebook.
Kangaroo. They thought for days and days at Kangaroo what to call it,
exactly.
And then someone said, wait a minute. The Kangaroo Notebook. Well, it works. Under
go.
$300. Is it out now?
It's available right now on Newegg.
Okay. Newegg.
You can just walk
and,
away with that computer in
your hand.
Your
website is kangaroo.com?
That's kangaroo.cc.
Kangaroo.cc. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest Writer, and the Giz Wiz One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv.
Oh, and there we go. That is incredible. Someone in my Twitch chat pointed out something that I thought was very funny. Which is, it's almost like those old PCI slots in reverse.
Yes! Yeah, you're absolutely right.
That's where, you know, you used to be able to extend the computer by putting something into the slot at the side of the computer. Now, that's the whole computer. That is absolutely everything when you put that thing in there.
So you know, it's the latest Atom chip, so it's the Cherry Trail. And it's that screen is 11.6 HD, has a trackpad, a battery, a webcam, a microphone, and it is on sale for 5 days at Newegg.
Ooh.
I'm glad you brought that up. It says last 5 days. It ends Monday.
Save $80.
You save $30, right?
Oh,
is that
nice.
What you said?
Yeah. Well, it says, well, I don't know. It depends on what MSRP is.
You know what?
Right.
It's funny. Every device has a fake MSRP.
Yes, exactly. So the highest price it'll ever be sold for is $350, but you'll probably normally see it for $300.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. So it says that it's 23% off, but normally it's probably just 5 or something.
Exactly. So it's a Windows 10 Home 64-bit. It's pretty clever. The thing is now, those PCs only work with that particular notebook. But it's really amazing when you think of it that if you want to do business on a computer and you have kids, there's no way they can hack into what you're working on.
Right.
Because you have your entire system in your pocket.
Right. Exactly. God, yeah. That's incredible to think about. Yeah. I mean, it's almost like spy agent stuff. It's like you come up to a security checkpoint.
It is.
Pull the computer out and hand it to them. Go, it's not working right now. It's incredible.
I think what they should do next is come out with a USB dongle that this can plug into.
Right.
Wouldn't that be great? So no matter where you go, all you have to do is carry this and the little adapter to USB.
That would be incredible. And on most computers, if you hold down like F12 while it's booting, you can boot into the BIOS and choose your boot disk. And
right.
So on any computer, as long as you turn it off, turn it back on, enter the BIOS, say boot to this drive, and now any computer is your computer that you carry around.
It's your
around.
Computer.
That's incredible. That would be amazing. Wow. I'm really excited about what Kangaroo is doing. Although it's still, I feel like a little bit gimmicky. Like I just don't see a big office.
Oh no!
You know,
not
switching. You know, but it's so cool.
It's cool. And you know, it's still just 2 gigabytes of RAM.
Right.
But just for laughs, I watched some YouTube videos. I visited websites. So you're not going to do video editing.
Right.
You can play Minecraft, but you can't play any of the big games.
Right.
But for a bare bones computer, for two people, chipping $150 each, and you have a notebook, and each person has their own little computer.
Yeah. I really like that. Yeah, that's very, very cool. Bleak saying you can already do that. Stuck Pixel saying you can already do that with live PC. I guess you're right, is you can boot and then all your data is there. But I guess you're right. I'm dreaming of a day where the computer would be like, oh, ignore all these other hard drives connected to the motherboard. Let's just only boot from this. Ignore the motherboard even. I guess that doesn't quite exist yet, but yeah, I understand what you're saying. That's pretty cool. So Kangaroo is still coming out with really, really interesting products. Very neat.
Yeah. Okay, another company that comes out with interesting stuff, and I apologize at the beginning that it's the lighting's a little off because there's a very bright monitor behind us and. He's showing us a keypad, but just keep in mind, the keypad he's showing us is a little mini keypad you have seen a million times, but when he explains what the new Lenovo one does, that's what makes it very interesting.
Dick DeBartolo, Maz Madness writer, and the Giz Wiz, one take theater here at gizwiz.tv. We're at Lenovo, and Lenovo, they really come up with unique things. At the last PepCon, they had the Android tablet with a illuminated keypad, and you would click it, and that would go out, and it became a tablet. Well, now we're looking at this little guy, and Joseph is going to tell us about, what's this called?
It's called the Lenovo 500 Multimedia Keyboard.
Okay, the Multimedia Keyboard. Controller, that's okay. And I was thinking, well, I've seen this before, until Joseph showed me what's neat about it. You don't have a touchpad, and we'll tell you why.
Yeah, so Dickie, like, the thing is, right, before you, this is not a new thing, right? The problem now is that most of the time we don't really type that much. We just need to like select a lot of stuff. So we tried to address that with this multimedia controller. So as you can see, it's still a full-size keyboard, so you can still type really well. But the cool part is like this entire keypad surface is your touchpad. So as I move my fingers across, it's moving my mouse. The cool part is that not only do you have a bigger real estate, but you could use gestures. So if I want to scroll up and scroll down, I could just use two fingers. There you go. That was pretty cool.
Neat.
So let's say I'm plugging this to my TV and I have like Netflix on, Amazon on, and a lot of stuff, and I want to like go back and forth to other apps. I could use the Windows gesture three fingers to swipe up, and there you go. All your applications, just select it with one tap. That's your left click. Boom. There's that. This will be priced $55, and it will be out April of 2017.
That is really clever. And $55 is excellent. I like it. Lenovo's, tell me the name again.
Multimedia controller.
Multimedia controller. Dick DeBartolo, Mads Madness writer, and the Giz Wiz. One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. I'm telling Mark, don't push the stop button yet, because if anything is wrong technically with this video, it is Mark, G-O-N-N-E-L-L-A. No, he's a good sport. Okay, bye.
That is awesome, and that would be super duper useful for home theaters, because you never, like, I've seen so many home theater setups where you're sitting on the couch having a good time and then we need to do something, and then out comes this humongous keyboard with an attached trackpad, and you set it in your lap and it takes up everything. You have to move glasses and the popcorn out of the way just to be able to handle this keyboard. So something that's small that fits in your hand is fantastic.
Yes.
And then having a whole keyboard be a trackpad.
Yeah.
I love it. I love it. I think somebody that I'll keep this in mind if I ever have my own PC.
Someone's saying that they wish the lighting was better. So basically, it's a keyboard you've seen a million times.
Right. We've
the
seen
the difference
those tiny
with this one is if you use your finger and hit keys, you're typing. If you just use fingers lightly and drag it over, the entire keyboard is your trackpad. So you drag down, the screen goes down. You push up, the screen goes up. So it's just a way to give you a touchpad the size of the keyboard. It's very ingenious.
I think it's very, very neat. And of course, the keys are not to raise. They're kind of those bubble keys. Use. I know, and it looks like there's a line here. I wonder, is there one right click versus left click?
You know, I think it might be. That's my guess is what that is.
It doesn't look, Lenovo's, it starts at $54.99. That is very reasonable. And man, I think that is fantastic. If I ever got a Media Center PC, this is definitely the keyboard that I would like to have around the couch and in the house. Wow, that's very nice. And priced at $55, if that's what stays, very good price. I could see that thing being in the hundreds, unfortunately. But wow, $55.
If you go on Amazon the week after it's released, you'll find someone trying to get 100.
Exactly. Definitely. You never know what you're going to get on Amazon. Very cool. Okay. Two great gadgets.
Okay. Now we have perhaps a third great gadget, and you decide.
Hey, Dick DeBartolo, Mads Maddest writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at gizwiz.tv. You know, we're at CES. There are a lot of trends. One thing I love is small. So take a look at this. How small can a charger be? We're going to find out here now from Itai.
Itai.
Okay. So tell us about this guy.
Okay. So this is Kado. Kado is the thinnest charger ever. We have a new patented technology that allows us to transform power in a new way. We believe that current chargers will be thing of the past, since this is a very unique technology. And it's ironic because while most of our devices are getting thinner and thinner, like laptops and
that'll be, people will be impressed with that. No, show us how it folds out.
Okay, so this is the charging unit. There are foldable prongs, and here you have the USB port. It has a detachable cable unit. The cable is wrapped around. There are 2 feet cable, and you just need to take it out and plug the prongs to the wall, to the outlet.
Oh, whoa!
Okay.
And you all set.
Oh, I completely misunderstood what that thing was.
The good thing is it's as thick as brick as the cards. It allows you to
put it in a wallet. Okay.
Have it always with you.
Okay, and now you have one for a laptop?
Yeah, we do. We have a very cool model for a laptop. As you see, it's as thin as a pen. And take a look. It's foldable. This is the first ever foldable charger for laptops.
And we have a security device on it now, which is why it's not folding back.
Yeah. We have also two USB outlets. It means that you can charge your laptop and additional device, like a tablet or phone or camera.
So give us an idea when these are coming out and what they'll cost.
Okay, so they will come out for pre-sale in the spring, and they'll be available in the market in Q2. The cost for the phone charger will be around $50, while the cost for the laptop charger will be around $100.
They are really amazing. If you like small things, like my brain, this is a great way to go. Dicky Bartolo, Mads Meditz writer, and the Giz Wiz, One Take Theater here at Eureka Park, CES 2017. Bye.
Okay, so I was thinking that it was a battery for the first half of that video, but now I realize that it's a wall charger, so the prongs kind of fold out, you slide in this extra bit, and now you have a little extendable USB wall charger. Wow, that is tiny.
And you know, I'm wondering, he said that the little plug part had a USB out, so do you even, if you have your own cable or...
Yeah,
if you have
confused.
Something that has a USB, do you even need the second part?
Right. You might just be able to, that's what it seems like. I mean, most
That's what it seems like, yes.
Yeah, definitely. Very small. It's funny that they put the security thing
in
right
the
in a way
is,
so you couldn't.
Is that the most ridiculous?
Very funny. But yeah, wow. It's hard to see because it looks like he was mentioning this is USB. So you could just plug your own device into the side of it. But now what someone very astutely pointed out in the chat room is that this would take up both, if you put it in the top plug.
Both out, yes.
It takes up both outlets. I don't know if it will on the bottom plug if you only, you know, aim for one.
You know, they're not polarized. So I have an idea he put it in with the bulk of the unit facing up, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, exactly. So I think, yeah, you're right. It doesn't seem like there's a larger prong versus a smaller prong, so you may be able to flip it any way you want. Very interesting, very small. I've never seen a charger this small. I mean, it seems like it's a little expensive, but it's a stylish charger. I mean, what else are you going to get with it? So...
If you're the kind of person who has some extra bucks and wants to say, hey, look at my charger.
Look at my thin charger.
Oh, yeah, right. Where's my credit card? Oh, that's not my credit. Oh, that's
my
phone charger.
I plug this into the wall later to charge my iPhone. yeah, exactly. Now, I mean, and the other thing is, I mean, I'm always up for travel gadgets, and putting chargers in my backpack, it takes up a lot of room. Those little bricks. You got one for your iPad, one for your phone, and then, of course, one for your laptop. If you could get something smaller for all of those, hey, I'm all for that. That's quite nice.
So, yeah. And $100 to the laptop thing is kind of what they're, you know, there's the Volt.
Yes.
I think last year we had the Volt. So, as a matter of fact, someone that, when I was looking at this thing, I said, oh, this is like the Volt, and the person in the crowd said, oh, didn't you know Volt went out of business already?
Oh, no.
Well,
yeah, Volt
they
were like a super fast charger that was super small.
Yes, and it was like, you know, it was like a tower.
Yeah.
With three USBs, and it was also a laptop charger replacement.
Right. The problem with the power supply industry is it's not like headphones where it's something that you really want, you need, and it needs to be stylish because it's going to be on your face. It's going to be plugged into a wall. It's to charge the computer. There's not a lot of people saying, if only this computer charged faster. You know, there's maybe those annoyances once or twice. So I don't think the luxury power market really exists. So I bet that's what Volt had a problem with.
That could be.
Just that there's not a lot of people that want to drop $100 so that they're... cell phones charge a little bit faster, unless if when you're actually, you know, buying the phone. I could kind of see it. If you're already spending $300, and it was packaged in with the phone. Get the slow charger, get the fast charger.
Well, the Bolt would charge, had enough power to charge your laptop.
A laptop,
and
too.
And your phone, yeah.
But I can tell you immediately, even me, someone who's technical, the first thought of, oh, charge a laptop, is it compatible with my laptop? How's that going to work? How do I make sure to get the right plugs? I don't know. I'm already like, spend $100 and not know if it's going to, charge my laptop. I'm out. And that's someone who's technical. My family, my extended family or immediate family, there's no way they would drop $100 on a charger that they didn't know was completely compatible with their laptop. But anyway, three fantastic gadgets. And now for a not so fantastic gadget.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to...
You don't need it, but you might want it at Chad's Crappy Corner.
And I should explain, the theme for January is gifts Chad got from his family.
From my family.
The sub-theme that we dare not mention is that his family watches this. And next year... gives him incredible stuff.
Yes, exactly. You know, I was afraid that it wouldn't be so crappy, but this one.
What did we have last week? Then
last week we had the toy driver. Where did I put that thing?
An ideal, fun gadget.
This looked perfect. This looked absolutely perfect, right? Unscrewing those itty bitty screws, which multiple times on the show I have gotten upset about. Why do gadgets come with these stupid screws? Well, hey, this gadget doesn't come with any screws at all.
Okay.
It is called Angry Mama, and I recorded a video earlier in my kitchen, so we can just go ahead and take it away, me from the past.
Hey, Diggy D, it's Chad from earlier in the day, and today we're checking out Angry Mama. It's a way to clean your microwave, if I haven't already said so before this video. It's a pretty simple construction. You just have three pieces. So you have the head piece, the hair piece, I guess, the face
red
piece,
hair,
and then the body piece. And the body piece has on it some vinegar and water levels. So we're going to use those to fill her up. All it takes is vinegar and water.
God, we have a great kitchen.
I love that kitchen.
It's really nice.
Whoa. So what's interesting is there's like a bonnet on the Angry Mama, so it's really hard to see the vinegar level.
So here we go to the water line.
But when you get up to the water, you use the neck, which is only one thick, and it's much easier to see.
Oh, I see. Okay. I can see what you see. Yep, I see.
Now you put it all back together. Then you place it in the microwave for 7 minutes on high.
Whoa!
The microwave currently smells of popcorn and not such great things. We're going to throw it in there.
I think most people's microwaves smell like popcorn.
7 minutes.
So yeah, 7 minutes seemed like a long time.
There she is, turning round and round, dancing.
And she's melting, I'm melting.
We're still got about 6 minutes on this, so we're going to let that go for a little while. She's,
and that sounds like
oh my
powerful.
Gosh, it smells so much like vinegar. Okay, so we're coming up to the end of the Angry Mama timer here. Right in front of the microwave, it definitely smells very, very vinegary. It says for 2 minutes before doing anything. So we're going to wait a little bit for this to cool down, and we'll be right back. Okay, so it's been a little bit of time, and we are going to pull the Angry Mama out. It suggests using the arms to do so, because it's lighter, and then hopefully we can just wipe this thing down. You can kind of, it's getting some stuff in there. If you look way down in there, there's some, I don't know what that is. It comes just right off. There you go.
Boy, compared to my microwave, yours is pretty good.
Oh, it's a newer microwave, so you know, only since April has it been used.
Oh, okay.
Now, we have replaced popcorn smell with vinegar smell, so I don't know if I would call that a victory, but that has at least happened. So yeah, we're pulling out some stuff from the inside up at the top. Yeah, I would say that it definitely loosened up all the things inside of the microwave, but now it definitely smells a lot like vinegar. Hopefully that'll go away. Okay, so that was the Angry Mama. There doesn't seem to be a lot of liquid in the bottom. Very briefly, some water started to come out of the top of the hair, but that didn't seem like that was very normal. That only happened for a few seconds. And that is the Angry Mama. I would say mediocre, yeah. It's okay. It definitely smells a lot like vinegar. But I think that when that dissipates, I'll have a clean microwave.
Okay, so now, back in present time, the vinegar smell is everywhere. My entire house smells like vinegar. I went out to check the mail, came back, vinegar. The cats have been walking around all day going...
Holding their nose.
Yeah, looking around, trying to find the source of this this vinegar. I would say the microwave is clean, but you do have to put up with vinegar throughout the whole house. So that's the big downside of the Angry Mama.
So you would just use opening something it else up the it's next like, time, right?
Yeah, I mean, part of me is just like use 409, let it soak for 30 seconds, and then wipe it out. The nice thing is that you're not putting really any chemicals into a place that you prepare food. So, you know, spraying 409 or something inside of a microwave could be bad if you don't absolutely dry up absolutely every little bit. Where the Angry Mama, it's just vinegar. And
well,
it does do a good job.
The next time you cook a meal, if your meal comes out still tasting like vinegar.
Yes, that's when I know that it's really like a two-star product.
That'll be Angry Chad.
Exactly. I don't want my food to smell like vinegar. So now there's another interesting thing about Angry Mama, and that is there is not a single manufacturer that I can pin down as to who makes the Angry Mama. If you search on Amazon, you will find so many different Angry Mamas. This is the Angry Mama that I found that was looked like the least expensive. It's not Prime, but it is $4.78. So if we just did a quick search for Angry Mama, you can see we may have to look in all departments here. There are just a lot of Angry Mamas out there. To choose from. It seemed like earlier I was finding a ton more. I do know that this is a product that if you go to like Alibaba, there are lots and lots and lots of Angry Mama look-alikes. There we go. So you can see, you know what? Am I spelling angry wrong?
A-N-G-R-Y.
A-N-G-R-Y. There we go. A-N-G-R-Y. Angry Mama. I don't know how to spell.
Nothing came up.
There we go. M-A-M-A. There we go. Okay, this is the source of my frustrations. Is that I don't know how to spell. There we go. Okay, so let's do this one more. There we go. This is what I was finding earlier.
Wow.
Yes. Wow. Yes. There are so many Angry Mama lookalikes. They come in 2-packs. They come in 3-packs. You can get any Angry Mama that you want. Okay, I'm glad I figured that out because that was embarrassing. It was like, there's three. Look at these three products. but yes, so there are
lots.
Oh,
wait a minute. New Angry Mom. Go back up a bit. New Angry Mom.
I have.
It looks exactly like
the same as this one.
Right above.
Right? So I really have no idea what to recommend, what not to recommend. This is the one from New Metro.
I don't think you have to recommend anything.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's like if you really, really, really need to clean your microwave with vinegar and water, this is, really isn't going to do much. I mean, it the top may make sure that it doesn't boil over, but that's not very amazing. Luckily, you can get it for really cheap. If you go to Alibaba, you can buy them for $1 to $2. It's going to take a while to ship to you. But you can see that this is probably one of those products that got popular. Some factories in China were able to duplicate it, and duplicate it they have. There are, I mean, this is, if you get 1,000 pieces, you can get it as low as 85 cents. Or 45 cents for 10,000 pieces.
Wow, well, let's get 10,000 of them.
Let's get 10,000. I mean, that's only, what, $40,000? Something like that. So, yeah, so there's a lot of angry mamas out there. This one, the brand is New Metro Angry Mama. So if you absolutely have to clean your microwave with an angry mama, you can. I would say your house is going to smell like vinegar. And prices and products may vary. This one I found for about $5. With that, let's move on to Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
They're geeky and they're goofy. Together they are loopy. When gadgets pass away, he takes them out to play in Dick's Gadget Warehouse.
Foghorn. Okay, so Dick's Gadget Warehouse, take it away, Dickie D.
Okay, it came with this letter. Hi, Dick and Chad. Thanks for a wonderful show. I wrote in once or twice years ago and wanting to share some of the items from my museum case at the university where I work. Work always seems to take up all my time when I'm there on campus, though I was finally able to grab some video clips and edit them together. So let's take a look. Let me just find out. This is from Bruce. So Bruce has some really great stuff on campus.
Hi, Dick and Chad. This is Bruce from the university where Leo's father used to teach.
Oh, cool.
And I thought you might like to see some of these things from our instructional technology museum case.
These are just a few of the items that are in our museum case, and I'll just show you one or two of them, and maybe a few more, just as still images to keep this under your 3-minute time limit. This is the first one. It's a 16mm film projector that had an unusual way of loading the film.
This is so neat.
Anyone who's loaded these by hand knows that it can be kind of a pain. So you just clip the film onto this green bar that goes up the middle of it, and then that green bar, when you press the load button, will swing all the way around through the film chain and move the film over the various wheels that it needs to load through, and the lens will swing out of the way.
Oh, wow. That green
bar. Isn't that neat?
There. And then all you have to do is unclip the film from the green bar, and you're ready to start playing the movie.
Wow.
And the next item that I'm going to show you is a megaphone, what people used to amplify voices before we had
That one has a volume control.
Didn't get quite loud enough, so we added that volume knob to it. And the film strip projector, this one's from about 1910, at the tone.
Wow.
Change to the next slide. Beep. Digital, some of the first consumer cameras.
Oh
that
my
used,
God.
Floppy
Love those
discs,
stickers.
And one
on
of the first 35mm film SLRs. A large format slide projector that I always thought looked like something
looks
from
like
Flash
a,
Gordon.
A ray gun, yeah.
Yes. And this.
A 3D ViewMaster with a actual little clear record that was attached to the ViewMaster slides so that you could listen to audio along with the stereo slides as you click through.
Never saw that.
You can see that record there. And one of the first remote controls, you see those little bars at the front. When you press the button, it would send an ultrasonic tone.
Wow.
This is actually a microphone. It looks like one of those candlestick phones, but it's a microphone. A speaker that used a horseshoe magnet instead of a toroidal magnet. Reel-to-reel Carpenters, Peter, Paul, and Mary, and 8-track Linda Ronstadt. And before that, we had wire recorders. People actually recorded on wire.
What?
As a magnetic media before we had recording tape. And, of course, before that were Edison cylinder recorders. And then we'll go on to see-through Macintosh and lots of other things, but we've run out of time, so I'll have to come back at the next time.
Wow, that is really cool. That is like a gadget warehouse extravaganza. That is amazing. I like the volume knob because at first I was like, oh, it's analog, and then I was like, oh, it's digital. And I was like, oh no, it's analog.
Oh yeah, you know, you probably never even heard of ViewMaster, right?
No, oh no, I have.
Okay.
Yeah. We had one of the original red ViewMasters at home, and a few of the discs. And then what's funny is ViewMaster recently has gotten into the virtual reality market, and you can buy ViewMaster cell phone holders, and you can use their ViewMaster app with your cell phone, and it's basically one of those VR headsets that I've even shown a few of. Yeah, in the crappy corner.
Right.
So ViewMaster is still around.
Did you know they made ViewMasters with a soundtrack?
No, never knew that.
I never saw that.
I've never seen that. I mean, and it was a record. I mean, how? I can't imagine the mechanism that would make sure that would play in any sort of consistent quality. I mean, holding a ViewMaster. There's some record player here with a speaker down here. And, you know, it's a handheld device. I've never seen a handheld meant to move around while it's playing record player. Yeah, I bet that was, and then it looked like the clear record was over, that's fine, because, I was gonna say it was over the pictures, so you'd have to look through the record, but the record was on the opposite side, and all you need is light, to push those around, so, God, that was insane. Yeah. I also never knew that people used wire instead of,
Yes, they did, wire was even before my time. But I do remember reading that the reproduction was crappy because there was no way for the wire to go through playback exactly the way it went through recording.
Right.
It was a piece of wire.
Right. It was round.
It was round, exactly.
Oh, my gosh.
Exactly. Yeah.
That is crazy.
And I think an uncle of mine had one up in his, or down in his cell, and he showed me, and while he was playing it, the wire broke and spools of wire went all over the floor. But Bruce has a request, okay?
Okay.
So he says, these are a few of my oddities, old media and computing equipment we use in classrooms in years past, donated from retiring faculty and staff, and some are on loan from technicians. If anyone is interested in donating, we are looking for an old chopper wheel television set. I don't know what that is. A SideQuest Magneto optical drive. Don't know what that is. And something called a hectograph. Apparently, the hectograph was the precursor to the Ditto machine. Oh, basically, a block of gel you would put some sort of resistance on, ink up, and print copies on it one at a time.
Wow.
Anyway, well, Bruce, we've thrown it out there.
Man.
We have some old listeners, but I don't think we go back that far.
So, and how would they get a hold of him?
You know what? They can email. They can send it to mail at gizwiz.tv.
Send it to mail. And we'll forward it.
And I'll send it right on to Bruce. So, Bruce, you get February Mad. You get one of those 30-plus-year-old Alfred E. Newman pictures. We're still looking for more videos. That was a great video. I think we have one more in-house now. So, old stuff you have, something new you have in love, something new you have in hate. Make a little video, 2 to 3 minutes, put it on YouTube. Check that thing unlisted. When you upload it, it'll say public, but hit the drop-down menu and you'll get unlisted. Don't do private because then only you can see it, not us. Click unlisted. If we show it, you get a Mad and the Alfred picture. If you live in the U.S. or Canada, if you live outside the country, we will give you a shout-out. Mail at gizwiz.tv. So we have something for next week, but we need something rather quickly for the week after.
Perfect. With that, let's move on to the letter.
Okay, from Braden Williams. Oh, a name we can pronounce.
Woo-hoo! Wow.
Braden, or, well, at least I can pronounce it.
Once.
B-R-A-D-E-N, Williams. Williams, yay. Something you guys might like, the rechargeable CR2032 battery.
What?
I'm not sure if you had something like this. No, we never had. I got tired of buying CR2032s to put in my Smart Things presence key fobs. I suspect they could be used in just about anything that uses 2032 batteries. Before I found this device, I would take CR2032s out of old computers, use them until they started getting low, and put them back into a PC I had taken apart. And let them charge up for a few days. Oh my gosh, Braden, you go a long way for
wow.
a 2030.
Yeah.
So I can see why he has lots of computers at his disposal. Senior systems engineer at Genesis Systems LLC.
Interesting.
And they're at genesis.com. But you know what? That's a little, go back up. That's kind of pricey.
Yeah, right? $25 is definitely expensive.
Unless you are using tons of them. It's so funny because I just got 25 yesterday for $10.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. What is that?
I'm trying to see the amount. It doesn't actually say. It looks like these are also different.
No, it also says just 5 of them.
Yeah. So here, let's go back. Let's search for CR2032s. This is a pretty big pack right here. You got.
This is what I bought.
20 pieces. Oh,
so yeah. I got 20 pieces for
$9.
$9. So I paid about 40 cents.
I've bought this as well at May.
Oh, how funny!
Apparently, I too have purchased the 20-pack of CR22.
I like it because they're from Sony, aren't they?
Yeah, Sony CR2032s. Yeah, Sony.
And they're dated like 2026 or something.
Yeah. Interesting. Now, what's the one reason why this seems intriguing to me, even though it's $25, is right now I have these little sensors that work with my it's basically a thermometer that works with the thermostat, so I could put a sensor in a room and it would tell my thermostat the temperature in that room so that it can kind of regulate the air conditioning and furnace throughout the house a little bit better. Those things eat up batteries. It feels like it is once a week I have to replace those batteries. I stopped because I just felt like I was going through too many batteries. Like after the third time I replaced them. And so if I had a rechargeable kind of thing where it's like, I can just pull the one out of the charger, place it in, put the old one in, that seems reasonable.
It's also, more environmentally friendly.
Right, exactly. Exactly. So, or maybe I have a broken Ecobee little sensor, so I don't know. But interesting. It's good to know there's rechargeable ones out there.
Whoever knew that there were such things as a rechargeable 2032 battery?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Braden, thank you so much for that. Oh, I'll ask you another question. Luckily, I was able to print my script. I don't know if other printers have this quirk, but on HP printers and on their website, it's dozens of them. Do you know you cannot print a black and white document if any of the three color cartridges do not have ink in them?
That seems unreasonable and unfair. Wow.
Just to be true. Now, they give the reason, which makes it a little more tolerable. The reason is that a lot of people use black and white, and the color cartridges start to dry up. So by throwing a tiny bit of color into everything black and white it prints, it keeps the print heads
open and fresh and
open
working.
And fresh. But there should be override.
Right. Something. I'm running late for my meeting and I just need a black and white thing. Forget it for today.
You know, the chat room is saying I am I'm badly audible. That's true, but
yeah,
barely audible.
Yeah, turn you up there just a bit.
Oh, okay.
But yeah, so very, very weird that you need.
Yes.
That you need that. It just doesn't make any sense.
No. Well, the thing is, I've never had it happen, except tonight I don't have any spare color. And fortunately, right. I had just finished printing the script when it said, you can no longer print.
You were out. We're out of cyan. You need more cyan. Come on.
Get out of here and find a printing store that's open now.
That stinks. That stinks. But you know what doesn't stink? Giving away gadgets.
Oh, yes, your new thing.
Yes. So for the month of January, because we didn't ask our patrons what the theme should be, because I stole it to show off my parents' stuff. We're giving away some gadgets this month to some patrons. So we went up to random.org and ran the random number generator once again. And Sonic Tonic is the winner of Toilet
Steamboat
Tunes.
Mama.
Exactly. Slightly smelly. You know what? I'd throw in Angry Mama. No, I can't re-gift. This is a gift from Mom and Dad.
Oh, no. That's right. You're right.
Tunes. Make some tunes on the toilet just for you. We showed these off. We actually thought it was very fun. I hope maybe you have kids or maybe you want to just impress some people at a party or something like that.
That guy... lives high. He has toilet tunes.
He has some toilet tunes in there. It's still on. Am I allowed to ship this with batteries? I'm not sure.
Yeah.
Maybe you're musically inclined, but
yeah.
There you go. Some toilet tunes for you.
Well, you know, you could put it next to your bed, too, if you want to get out of bed and tap out a tune.
It doesn't. I know that it says toilet tunes on the very top, but, you know, it doesn't need to be toilet tunes. You can make this bed tunes or couch tunes or Giz Wiz tunes. Just play the Giz Wiz tunes whenever.
Backseat of the car tunes.
Yeah, exactly. Floor mat tunes.
There you go.
Anything. Airplane tunes. I don't think anyone's going to be upset if you start playing some nice tunes on an airplane full of people.
And I'm not so sure.
So there you go. Thank you so much, Sonic Tonic, for your generosity and support of the Patreon. And, of course, we love our patrons so much. You guys make the show happen every single week. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Especially in these dry spells when we just don't have any sponsors, you guys are really the only thing that keeps the show going. So thank you so much. If you're unfamiliar with what Patreon is, it's a platform for people to support independent content creators like ourselves. Our page is at patreon.com/gizwiz. And big thank you to the 294 people. We're almost at 300 people.
Yeah.
Woo. For supporting the show. You guys really, really, really make the show happen. Thank you so, so, so
but
much.
But, Chad, I don't want to have to give every month. Isn't there a way I could give just once?
You can. We will take that money. If you head on over to gizwiz.tv, there's a Patreon tab, but don't be fooled, because right underneath the big Patreon banner, if you want to give just once, and we've had some fantastic donations this month as well, there's a PayPal link if you just want to send me and Dick PayPal. And that gets split between me, Dick, and our producer. It goes directly to funding this show. Funding things like CES tickets and hotels and things like that. Or gadgets. It went to Toilet Tunes, let me tell you. Thank you so much to our patrons. You guys are fantastic. Before we go, check out What the Heck Is It over at gizwiz.biz. While you're at gizwiz.biz, you can check out all the show notes that Dickie D writes up about the show, but click on the banner right on the side to see what the heck is it, and this is what we are guessing what the heck it is, and it is obviously a stair trainer for ants. For ants.
That's a good guess.
Yeah, it's, you know, ants have to work out too. So there it is. If you know what that is, there's 12 Mad Magazines for correct answers, but 24, double the Mad Magazines for funny, hilarious, cute, and clever answers. So get a guessing over at gizwiz.biz. We record this show every Thursday. You know what? I have not confirmed whether or not I will be here next week. Last episode, we were talking, we're going to be here for for months and months and months. And then after the show, I realized that I may be heading to PAX South on Thursday next week. So next show, we'll have to check Twitter to see what finally gets decided on that.
And check our website, because we check always change the banner at the top.
We do. We have this nice banner right up there.
It might be Wednesday night instead of Thursday night.
Right, exactly. It may be, okay. I have to confirm, there's a show that I may be a part of on Thursday, which would mean that I'd want to be there. Anyway, it's complicated. So I need to confirm with other people to make sure that Thursday is a day that I need to be there or not. But if you don't catch the show live, we record 4:30 Pacific, 7:30 Eastern time.
Oh, we're recording this now.
We are. I figured that out.
That is,
I know.
It was really tiresome when we would...
The whole theater mode.
And someone would say, Chad, someone's got to watch.
Yeah, and it was really difficult when people would scroll. I mean, and they'd say, skip ahead 30 minutes. I don't remember. Oh, no. Yeah, that was really difficult. I'm so glad that we're recording.
You're recording it on that ViewMaster thing, right?
Exactly. Yes, with a clear record for audio. Yeah, definitely. It's a little better now. But we have episodes up at gizwiz.tv. Oops, sorry for the audio hit. And there's show notes and links to all the products that we talk about, and also links to gizwiz.biz, where Dickie D wrote up about them. So lots of stuff. Our home is at gizwiz.tv, and Dick's home is at gizwiz.biz. Thanks so much for watching this episode of the Giz Wiz, and we will see you next week.
And I'll be here.